Bill Walichko, welcoming you to Much More Music's world headquarters in downtown Toronto. How you feeling? Are you excited? Well, you gotta be. You know, the word artist used way too loosely in this industry. As far as I'm concerned, Gord Downie fits that bill perfectly. He is a singer, songwriter, musician, poet, author, actor, director, and a Canadian cultural icon. He has just stepped forth with a brand new solo disc called Battle of the Nudes, and we got him. He is here tonight to talk and to play. This is Intimate and Interactive with Gord Downie.
Cause you're here, and when you go, I'm going to.
I'm here, cause you're here, when you go, I'm going to.
I'm here,
cause you're here, when you go, I'm going to. I'm here, because you're here, when you go, I'm going to. I'm here, because you're here, when you go, I'm going to. You can do it here, because you're here. Do it all of you in here. I'm going to. I'm here, because you're here. When you go, I'm going to. I don't see your lips moving, but I see your eyes working overtime. When you go, I'm going to. I'm here, because you're here. It's not that tough. Come on. I'm going to. I'm here, because you're here. And when you go, I'm going to. As neutral as snow, covering up violence, your mind is smashing its gear. I like the Who by Road, a good old Monterey, where some people cheered, some looked away. The best words, the most economical and clear to the ear, are nullified and kept by mum, protectors of your suicide notes. And the best part of cold as far away is close, and the distant bark of a lone snow shovel digging out after the storm is a rhythmic whisper. That's right, it says, I'm here, because you're here. And when you go, I'm going to. I'm here.
Thank you. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Oh, yeah. Oh, oh, yeah. Oh, so this is your number. Well, I just called to say hello. I was flirting, you were flirting, we were talking in Morse code. We just got cut off or disconnected, I don't know, but it's Christmas time in Toronto. We've got this power to generalize when everything explodes. The certainty of our unknown, our children's unknown. You're gonna let us in, though you're technically closed. It must be Christmas time in Toronto. Let's have a toast. Charity, wickedness, dope. Day after tomorrow. Oh, yeah, the day after tomorrow. Oh, yeah, the day after tomorrow. Oh, oh. Bar, take us all to the show. You're so full of cash tonight, you could buy the Pope. But we might as well try and get milk from your elbow, even though it's Christmas time, Toronto. With your dark epiphanies, your true lines, your smoke, your glistening rails and streetcars all aglow. Always near wind and the persistent snow gets into your eyes and your mouth and every fold of your coat. Oh, everyone hates you. you, but they don't know what I know. Besides, it's Christmas time, Christmas time in Toronto. Let's have a toast to clarity, fixedness, hope. Day after tomorrow. Oh, yeah, the day after tomorrow. Oh, yeah.
I thought I'd never find.
It's the country of miracles. All right. So much for paradise. July 1st, this is a song for our friends out in the West Coast who get all of us heading out there for our last chance at romance. Because if you can't make it there, you can't really make it anywhere. As a couple, I mean, of any sex. It's the most beautiful place in the world. I tried to say that like Elvis, so you'd know I meant it. The most beautiful place in the world. All right. What the hell is this? You said it's art, just fucking mirroring. Where did we go wrong? If not here, where do we belong? In a shot of sun of an airplane far above us. In the glint of them foot-burnished manhole covers. In a light or sign of one kind or another. In the gleaming eye of a fighter or a lover. Sitting here. So you know this is important. If not here, then when? If not now, then when? When a feather's unmovable force. When stampede's an obstacle. Train is hit, old transient horse. When we're a Vancouver divorce. Take your colors away. 'Cause I've grown more fearful of them every day. Swimming up your dark river to discover its source. A source of strange and unrelenting remorse. And I found the end of the world, of course. And it's not the end of the world. Just a Vancouver divorce. It's just a Vancouver divorce. We'll be right back.
lives, folks.
Country of Miracles right here. That sounded great. That sounded amazing. How you doing? I don't have to tell you that this band kicks ass, do I? I think you already know that. Oh, I don't have to tell you this band kicks ass. I think you already know that, don't you?
Oh, they're good, yeah. They like to have a good time.
I'm just gonna let you know that there's still a lot more music coming, and we're gonna give you your chance to hook it up with Gord in just a little bit, so please stay with us.
And interactive with Gord Downie, call 1-800-265-6824 or email us at gorddowney@muchmoremusic.com.
If you get comfortable enough to write a song as though you were talking to a friend, then that friend would sort of know exactly what you're saying all the time. Like you and your best friend, you don't even have to make sense.
I didn't want to go, I want to analyze your lyrics, because first of all, they're so obtuse. I think the metaphor is so personal that I haven't got a clue what it means to you. I only know what it means to me.
Yeah, well, I like to leave it at that usually.
with anybody. I can't come up with real pat answers about them just because it ruins it for me.
She kinda bit her lip. She used, I don't know.
Performance in and of itself is a kick. You know, it's such a entirely natural and yet entirely unnatural thing to do.
That's live music, and that's the beautiful thing.
Playing the music we want to play, making the music we want to make, and I mean, I have to keep coming back to it, but making a career out of our imaginations.
I feel very grateful because all of it just keeps pushing me forward, you know, and it's sort of, you know, we become pretty lustful for new things.
I'm with some pretty talented people who are really pushing me. They want me to play guitar solo, in fact. In my entire life, no one's asked me to play guitar solo yet, let alone demand it.
We are intimate and interactive with Gord Downie. These people here are been waiting here a long time, and they're very happy to see you. Take a seat, man. I'm thinking, watching those performances and the reaction, you have a good job in that a lot of people are smiling. You make people smile. And that's a very fortunate position for you to be in.
You mean those guys on stage are smiling?
Those people, the people in the room, the people in front of the stage, the people I'm sure watching at home.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah, that's good. Thanks. I'm smiling too.
And a lot of them knew the words, and Battle of the Nudes has been out for less than a month, and a lot of the people knew the words, which was very cool.
Yeah, that is.
Almost a misnomer to call this a solo album, though, because there's a band on the record, there's a band on the stage.
Yeah, it probably is a misnomer, because it's sort of a collaborative thing. These guys aren't really wallflowers, you know, and the five or so days that we've been together making this record, maybe 11, there's actually a few more than that, but... But yeah, anyway, I forget. I lost my train of thought. It's a misnomer, yeah. If it's solo, I'm an albino. All right. I said it.
You are comfortable with the term because obviously people have to call it something, but you are comfortable with the term solo artist.
Oh, yeah, I'm comfortable with any term, really, long as it's not 3 in the morning. You know.
Is it two careers happening simultaneously? It appears that way.
Well, yeah, I mean, a career is a career is a career. I don't play golf anymore, and I need something to do, and I need something to do. I like making music, and I like making music here in Toronto, where I can, you know,
yeah,
where I can get around on one of those rickshaws there, which is another thing I do as a sideline. I like to really diversify, but keep my cardiovascular for singing. I run the Place Your Ad Contiki tour. Lower mainland Toronto. No, I get on my bike and I ride my bike everywhere, and it's a very infinitely bikeable town. I really enjoy working here, living here. Yeah.
Well, maybe we'll talk about Toronto and some other of your favorite places across Canada a little
sure.
bit later. We're going to go to Bob, I believe. Bob outside has a question. This fella right here.
Yeah,
hey, Bob.
I just have a question regarding your opinion on celebrities using their position to further political statues and stuff like that, you know? Like, what do you think of artists? Do you think it's like their right to say these things, or should they bother, or...
You're not running for office anytime soon, though.
Yeah, no, I'm just curious. There's a lot of artists out there that use...
A lot of people want you to, but...
Yeah.
No, they don't.
A lot of people want you for PM, but what do you think about artists? Should they even bother, or is it their right, or are they going out of their way to...
Well, artists are citizens, citizens are people. If a mic is thrust in front of your mouth, I guess you can decline comment. If you have one, then I guess you should let her rip. And yeah.
Thank you.
Give her. Yeah. Or give her.
Cool with that, Bob?
That's great. Thank you very much.
Okay, we have a question all the way from Vancouver. If I can direct your attention to the monitor here, we have someone there that wants a question from you, for you.
Hey, my name's Alice, and I'm from Vancouver, BC, and I'm just wondering, how is songwriting different from writing a poem?
And now it's up to you to give us an answer.
Well, I really don't know, except that, you know, I think songwriting is kind of, is writing things that rhyme quickly with each other and really economizing what you do within the framework of the melody, right? You get the melody and you can hum it, and then you can hum it and hum it and hum it, and then, at least that's my new strategy, and then get lyrics that really fit that melody and be painstaking and wait for them and all that. Writing a poem, you can do a poem in like 10 minutes sometimes if it just feels right, and you look at it and you say, yeah, that really works, but...
It's just... So, what happened?
She's gone.
Oh. She wasn't really listening. That was
I wanted
just
her
on.
To clarify something.
Okay.
That wasn't live.
No.
No.
We don't have that much money to spend to get the satellite uplink from Vancouver.
I got
you. Know us, Gord.
Well, I had another thought, but it'll...
Well, looking at your career, it's interesting in that you can talk about the hip catalog this way, the two solo records, the book. You have made your career, as you said, out of your imagination, but I think more specifically just out of a love of words. You love words, and you love the way they sound and the way they go together and what they could mean and imply.
Right.
Is that true?
Well, sure. I mean, they're a great way to get around. What'd you say? See? Great way to get around. You know, I watched Neil Young play the night, Greendale at the ACC. And that was all about words, and there wasn't a spare word. Every word was moving the story forward. So yeah, I loved those a lot. That was like really something. Anyone's at that show?
We have a question from Thunder Bay right now. This is a phoner. Hello, caller, are you there?
Hello?
Hi, can you hear us?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Who are you?
Dave.
Hey, Dave, how's it going?
Oh, not too bad.
Hey, Dave.
Hey, Gord. I was wondering what book you're reading right now and if there's any authors that you kind of find inspirational.
I'm reading a book of poems, For Lizzie and Harriet by Robert Lowell at the moment, and The Gulag Archipelago, which Dale Morningstar from The Country of Miracles gave me. It's a required reading in this group because it mentions The Country of Miracles. You guys are good in those bleeps. I was totally swearing. Think of everything.
We have good people in the control room there. Yeah.
Yeah. And it's Toronto. It's what a town. Yeah. Yeah.
Well, an email question. This one's from Bowmanville. Jim Vaughn Evans. This is a huge fan of yours, and he loves both your CDs. He says, he hopes you don't mind that he's going to compare you to Bob Dylan in the sense that the people in the media are constantly trying to figure out you and your lyrics out, and you feel it necessary for the listener to get your songs. I think Jim deserves applause for being brave and admitting he doesn't get it. He doesn't understand.
Understand what?
The lyrics.
And at all.
Most of them.
Well...
Because if anyone can read the poetry book, and I went through it again last week, I think I have to admit, I scratched my head a few times. But again, there's that love of words and the way the words go together and they flow. And it says something to them where I don't think it was that to you when you were writing it. Does that make sense?
No, it's very brave, Bill. You know, sit here and... yeah, I don't know. I forget the question. Who is... I love those words so much.
The fact that he... Do you feel it necessary for the listener to get your songs, essentially?
Well, I don't know. I mean, you know, people like songs for a lot of different reasons, right? They, you know, they like the guitar riff, they love the drums, you know, they like the words, but not, you know, it's not a big deal for everybody, you know? So, yeah, I mean, getting them or not getting them or getting a fraction of them is cool. Sometimes I walk around with just a fraction of a song in my head, a line I can't get out, and I think that's cool, you know, because it somehow, you know, helps. May your faith give us faith. May your hope give us hope. May your strength give us strength. May your love give us love.
I get that. Okay. We're still going to be doing a lot of talking, and Gord and the Country of Miracles are still going to be performing, so we do not want you to go away because it all continues right after this. Intimate and Interactive with Gord Downie.
Canadian celebrity is kind of an oxymoron to begin with.
I don't really consider myself to be one thing or another. I would like to be too busy sort of doing it than,
right,
than calling it anything.
Do you consider yourself a nationalist?
No.
No.
No. And that would seem to denote a certain sense of superiority over others. Sounds hokey and everything. You hear your place name, or you hear something about where you, where you're at, or you relate to it somehow, and you go, yeah, and you just, it stays with you. It's indelible.
I want to know what it feels like to be massive Canadian icons here.
You know, I don't think it feels that different than being unmassive American icons.
Do you like being an icon?
Like made of wood? No, I can't move. I'm stiff all the time. You know, and water is a bitch.
This is Gord Downie. He is Intimate and Interactive. Still some more music featuring the Country of Miracles still to come. Watching that bit of tape there, it was brought up a couple of times, the word icon, and you've been tagged with that for several years now. And as fast as you are to deny being one, there are thousands and thousands of people out there that still call you that. You can argue all you want, but do you at least understand why people call you that?
I think I get it. No, I don't. No, I don't really. I mean, I don't really know what one is, necessarily. Don't you want to ask me how much my head weighs or something like that? Ah, that's a question I can answer. 8.
You have weighed it? You've weighed your head?
8 pounds.
Okay.
Well, 14 pounds. What?
Well, you know what I would love to do then? We can talk about hockey. You like
hockey? No, we can talk about anything. We can talk about anything.
You got the Boston Bruins on the cap there?
Yeah, that's the team.
Okay. Gord, you know what we have here? We have a pencil that won't come off my...
You're bringing the trivia in very early on in the show.
We have some hockey trivia for the Gord Downie here. We want to test your knowledge of our national pastime. Are you ready for this? And no
I'm
help from the audience.
I'm just checking with the band. Are we ready for this?
No help from the audience.
B.
What was the last year Boston Bruins won the Stanley Cup?
1972, May. Right. Okay. May 10th.
What team did they defeat in those finals?
Sorry?
What team did they defeat in the
72? New York Rangers, 5 games.
2 for 2.
This is, you know, there's a few people right now are, well, anyway, they're calling this T-ball. There's a few people out there right now, believe it or not, who are saying T-ball.
You don't want to do the questions?
I do want to do the questions, but, anyway.
What? I'm going to ask you one more question then.
Yeah, no, I'm sorry, Bill.
That's okay.
I'm being like Marlon Brando and Lou Reed, wrapped up in one.
I would say no to that assignment. I would never do that one. That would just be too difficult. How many Toronto teams, and this is just fascinating for anyone, how many Toronto teams have won the Stanley Cup?
What?
How many Toronto teams have won the Stanley Cup?
Oh, well...
Not how many times.
How many teams? Well, every team is different every year. Are you talking about...
Names.
What? I don't understand. Clarkie?
Well, okay, the Maple Leafs, the St. Pat's.
That's not my answer necessarily. That's just my attorney and drummer.
But, the answer is four.
St. Patrick's and the Leafs.
The Blue Shirts, the arenas, the St. Pat's, and of course the Maple Leafs.
I don't follow the Leafs. I do, in that I have to know them, and I know them well. I listen to the sports radio like crazy.
That's cool. That's okay. Danielle here.
Sports radio.
Danielle
it's
here.
Not good for you, but it passes the time.
Has the microphone, which means she has a question. How you doing, Danielle?
Good, thank you. Hi, Gord.
Hi, Danielle.
I was just wondering what your favorite band was when you were 13 years old.
When I was 13?
Mm-hmm.
I like this band from Toronto, The Dinner Is Ruined. Yeah, that's true. They've been around quite a while, because I'm 80. So that makes them, 96. When I was 13, my favorite band was probably Tom Petty and the Heartbreakers. I think. I bought that record. I thought they were like kind of new wavy, but not all the way new wave. So I could, anyway.
They were hip enough. Thank you.
I guess.
Good answer.
Well, Gord is dying to play, aren't you? And we know the band is getting ready. So after the break, you will see Gord Downie and the Country of Miracles on Intimate and Interactive with Gord Downie. Gord Downie and the Country of Miracles, Intimate and Interactive.
Thanks, folks. I'd do a little song if we could called Trick Rider. For a couple of gals I know.
Expect me to watch or
explain. Crumpling sound from over yonder by the steeplechase. It's a sound coming down like horses slamming on the bridge. It's the sound of the crowd, of the equine crowd in the vacuum of its age. It's the sound coming down like an entirely different breath. That's the sound coming down like El Paleo Sand Splain, and sprawling into a cafe in an explosion of table legs and trays. It's a sound from the stampede day.
Introduce you to the horn section, ladies and gentlemen. Pass it over to Dave Clark on the drums. Dave Clark
on the bassoon. Dr. Jeff Burke on the baritone saxophone. Mad Kenny Kirkwood in the middle, all the way from Lippincott Avenue, Dr. Breidenberg. Ladies and gentlemen, in the spectacles, the Jazz Beaver, Mr. Brody West. Next to him, the spherical sponge, Mr. Scott Cameron. The wood chopping horns, and let me tell you, you'll be hearing and seeing a lot more of those folks around town.
Na 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 na. Na 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 na. There's not a breath of air tonight. We got our windows all thrown open wide. Yeah, we're praying on any little breeze to move our curtains. Shake our leaves tonight. Yeah, I stumble into sleep's relief. Into a dream of pastel submarine. Yeah, if you can remain quiet and still, you might escape life's fill. Breath of air tonight. We got our windows all thrown open wide. Yeah, we're playing for any little breeze, for the skeletons, for the effigies.
Thank you, boys.
In a minute.
Big man.
A band and you're looking for some sort of longevity, there's certain sort of basic elements that you always draw upon, and it's one of them is probably that you're a fan of music first and foremost. As long as you can remain a fan, a big fan of music, then you can never be afraid of being infiltrated by contagious diseases like envy and jealousy.
You've done everything to ensure that what happens is what's best for the band.
We've done everything on our own terms, and so we feel that our biological clock is not ticking. We're going to be in this for a long time.
You're adopted, kicking in the borders of your hometown.
We really are linked by a common desire, and that's to have a career playing music.
We work hard all the time. We're fairly regular and orderly about things in hopes that we may be violent and original in our work.
Every bit of glory is distributed equally, and every torpedo hit is distributed equally. So, you know, I mean, that's our thing.
We are back. This is Intimate and Interactive with Gord Downie. Gord's playing, Gord's talking, and he's here, and still some of your questions to be featured. Getting back to Battle of the Nudes, it's been out for a couple weeks now, and everyone's singing along, which is great. They all have the record, they all know the songs. Is there a misconception that a solo album represents freedom? Because I'm thinking you were never restricted with your day job band.
There's nothing about freedom or restriction going on here, I don't think. I feel like, for me, it's important to have guitar cases in the front hall and you know, cables running here and there and drums set up. It's important to do what I do, work a day. You know, I want to do it every day, so I have to figure out how to do that. And I think that's what I'm doing, but it's really, you know, really hectic.
Lots of dates to come throughout the summer, or a few. They can access Wiener Art, W-E-I, wienerart.com, for dates. And also...
W-I-E.
W-I-E.
Yeah.
Oh. I think we keyed it wrong.
Sorry. You want to bring back the hockey trivia? I'm sorry about that before. I might have seemed like a P-R-I-Q-U-E, but I...
They were too easy.
No. You said they got harder, and who am I? I'm just saying, some people out there, because I'm a Bruins fan, and be like, anyway, all right, sorry.
Well, can you explain the downloading? It's a cool opportunity for fans to hear the shows that haven't been there, because a few days later, a week later, they're posted on Wiener Art.
Yeah, you can get them. If you want them, I guess if you were at that show, it might be a nice souvenir or a evidence. But I guess it's interesting to me because we're a band that starts in June and finishes in August, and I guess I'm lying. The police are coming.
Someone did something wrong.
I don't know if you know this, but in Toronto, it's a new thing. Just come down. Yeah, you can go to jail for... Anyway, what was I saying?
There's also some things they're not going to bust you for, though. So.
Right. Yeah, I think that's what just... Anyway. What were we talking about? Yeah, the downloads.
Yeah.
So if someone wants, they could get all of them and see a band sort of move its way through a tour. And because we're obviously committed to each other, we're having a good time and trying to have fun on stage.
You're not mic'd.
Precisely. No. You should meet these guys, you know. I think their parents are watching and... You know?
Well, we know Lori in Halifax is watching. She's on the phone right now. She has a question for you. Hello, Lori.
Hi.
How you doing?
Hi, Lori.
I'm good. Hi, Gord.
How's it going?
Pretty good. How's it going with you?
Pretty good. I'm on Queen Street here in Toronto.
Well, I'm in Halifax, Nova Scotia.
Is it raining?
No, it's actually really nice today.
Yeah, it's nice here, too.
Okay.
Was that your question?
I wanted to ask Gord, when you get writer's block, how do you get through it?
A lot of coffee. You know, I find I guess that what I'm doing right now is fighting it off somehow, or maybe I'm just living in abject fear of it, Laurie. So I stay busy, and I don't stop. And I guess when all else fails, then you can just sort of live your life and go about your business. And thanks, man. I guess you say thanks, Dad, right, or something like that. Yeah, all right. Anyway, yeah, so you just try not to stop for too long and keep it moving. It's sort of like a... well, as you can see, in Toronto, people just lob in songwriting advice from everywhere. Everyone's a songwriter here, Laurie, so I suggest come to town, come to Toronto and lose your writer's
blog. And get yelled at. Thank you very much for calling, Laurie. We appreciate it. We have a question from Toronto right now, if you want to look at the monitor.
Hi, this is Bubbles from the Sunnyvale Trailer Park, and I'd like to f***ing ask Gord Downie a question. Me and you worked out a deal about that engine, and I'd like to know where my f***ing macaroni salad is, because it never showed up.
Gord's going to give us some chicken if we get him a new motor.
How much chicken?
One bucket.
One bucket? Are you f***ing in the head? Macaroni salad.
Chocolate cake.
Corn buns, butter.
And I'd like to know where my f***ing macaroni salad is. Because it never showed up, and that was part of the deal, and I won it. Please?
Just a second, Bubbles.
Wait.
Just a sec.
Go ahead. No.
Bubbles, I think it's here. I got it somewhere in my... Oh, yeah, here it is.
Macaroni salad, warm buns,
jerseys.
I think, you know what? I think Bubbles is the new icon. The new
yeah,
Canadian
an
cultural
icon.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
And Ricky and Julian.
Yeah. Can I direct your attention across the street? Some guy's enjoying a cold one on this hot night in Toronto here, and he's got a question for Gord. I believe his name is Gord, too. Hey, Gord.
Hey, Gord.
Hey.
I got a two-part question for Mr. Downie. First of all, I was wondering what it's like playing the small venues again. And number
like
two...
One.
I was wondering if you'd like to come over and have a beer with us.
Do we have time, Bill?
We got a little TV show to do, but we're almost done, so maybe we'll head over for a couple of pints. Why not?
Very deft.
You're all invited,
Gord,
by the way.
Yeah.
I'll take a rain check.
All right.
All right. Have a great night. You too.
Thanks, Gord. And thank you, Gord. And we have more with Intimate Interactive with Gord Downie coming up right after this. Welcome back. This is Intimate and Interactive with Gord Downie and the Country Miracles.
Yeah.
A thousand times in the narrow flume of my mind. No, would I give just one small caress? Ah, it was a look in your eyes when you said something like, are you
Finlayson. I must say, I paid extremely close attention in the production meeting this morning. However, I'm not sure. We just keep on playing. I guess we just keep on playing. Here's a song about a dream I had. I saw you running with your friend. I called your name too loud, come back. So many times
might have been embarrassing if you hadn't come walking back. Here's where I shook you by the shoulder, shoved you up against a truck. What's up? It was a picture of someone getting older and of someone growing up. Someone's growing up. Someone's growing up.
Here we go.
Someone's growing up. Someone's growing up. It was like you was in disguise. You were so nonchalant. Come on, as though your well half-lidded eyes said, what the hell do you want? Well, I must have said something for you to feel I was all right, 'cause we had a great conversation, went on well into the night, went on well into the night. Went on well into the night. Went on well into the night. Went on well into the night.
Gord Downie, the country of miracles. I'm thinking, I don't know, maybe one more song? Maybe some Canada Geese? How do you feel about that? Gord Downie and the Country of Miracles.
Mr. Goatee.
Just to start.
Happy Canada Day. Yeah. Thank you.
Take a banner.